Hello and welcome back everyone. In this video, we will discuss how to build an application retrieving and displaying data from the Movie Database API web service in RAM. We will build this application in few simple steps. Before using any API web service, the first requirement is the API key. In this application, we are using the Movie Database. So the first step is go to www.themoviedb.org, create an account and request an API key. Once you enter the Movie Database website, you will find two options at the top right corner, login and join the Movie Database. If you are not having any account on the Movie Database website, you can go to join TMDB and fill the details. Once you create your account, you can log in to your account. Now go to the top right corner and click on profile and settings. Here you will find an option for API. Click on that. You can request your API key here. I am already having an API key for this website, which is shown here. And I will be using this for my application. After requesting your API key, please review the documentation of this API web service from here. In our application, we will search a movie by its name and display the information about that movie on the screen. So in the documentation section, go to search and we will be searching a movie by its name. So search movies. Read this information properly for the proper implementation of this web service. Step 2. Create a new project in VAM and add the following. First, fields and a database list where you can store the search results of the web service. I am naming this application MovieDB API. Go to the data model and create a new list in the data model. Name it search movie. That will be our database list. Create few fields in the search movie database list that will store the results of the API web service. Like name, increase the word limit of the overview, this is done because the overview will be a long paragraph containing information about the movie. So I have added four text fields in the search movie database list: name, original language, original title, a boolean field adult, and a number field release date. Now add two new data fields in the data model. Name the first one as JSON file, which will be of text type, and store the response from the web API service. Second text field is movie title. Now let's move to the flowchart tab. Click on home flowchart. Now it is a good practice to clear the database before starting any flowchart. This way I have cleared my database before starting my flowchart. Now the next step is an interaction node where the user can enter a search string. Drag an interaction node and name it search. Click on the interaction node and complete the template of the interaction node. Drag a form and drag movie title into this form. Now create a new button exit. Name it search. Change the appearance of the button and then save the template. The next step is a web request to the movie database API web service method get/search/movie. To complete this step, drag a HTTP request node here. Write the URL given in the documentation of the movie database website here. Select get method. In the response body, select JSON file, then click on edit query fields, add a query field API key, copy your API key from the movie database website. And paste it here. Add another query field, query. And drag movie title here. Leave all other options default. Connect this HTTP request node to the interaction node with the help of search button exit. Now the next step is functionality to transfer data from the return JSON file to your database list. Let me elaborate it more. The response of this HTTP GET request is a JSON file that needs to be imported to our database so that the information can be displayed. To do this, drag a import node here, select JSON, select data source file, select JSON file. Now connect this import JSON node to the HTTP request node, default exit. Now the next step is an interaction node displaying the search result. Drag a new interaction node, name it results. Click on this interaction node and put a JSON file here as label. Save the template. After saving the template, go to the home flowchart and connect the interaction node . Now click on preview . Search any movie like Wrath of Man. Click on search. The result is shown in the form of JSON file. Copy this JSON file . Go to the modeler Go to import JSON node and then complete the mapping by clicking on create from example. Paste the JSON file here and then click on OK. Complete the mappings of the import node. Map results to the search movie database list. Adult to adult. Original language to original language. Original title to original title. Overview to overview. Now complete the mapping by clicking on save button. Now again go to the result interaction node. Create a data grid that will show the result of the search. Original title, original language, overview, adult. Okay. Then create a new button exit. Name it exit. Change the appearance of this button exit and save the template. Now complete the flowchart. Then save database changes. And then navigate to home. Now our application is ready for testing. Click on preview to test your application. Search any movie. Click on search button. This is the JSON file and below it we are having our data grid. And when I click on exit button, it will revert back me to the home page. So our application is working properly. Thank you everyone for watching this video.